Good evening, good evening. This is Marie Holiday. I hope everybody had a fabulous day today. Please don't forget to hit that subscribe button and hit that notification button. And I really do want to thank all of my supporters and viewers for viewing my videos. Actually, this upload I'm about to do is based off, I'm doing it from a comment I received from one of my subscribers in relation to insight on Billie Holiday heroin addiction. Insight on Billie Holiday heroin addiction. So pay attention. And as a licensed clinical addiction specialist, you know, I'm going to present it from a standpoint of my expertise in addition to or along with the research that I gathered from researching the legendary Billie Holiday. You're not going to get the Hollywood version, I'm here to tell you. During her time, Billie Holiday was like the symbol of everything America had to be afraid of. She had a heroin addiction because she had been chronically raped as a child and was trying to deal with the grief and pain of that. Billie worked as a prostitute alongside her mother in a brothel. But most importantly, Billie was resisting white supremacy. Billie was not controlled by the record label. Billie Holiday danced to the tune of her own beat. She really did. I encourage everyone to read her autobiography. She was guided by something much more bigger and powerful than the record label. She was guided by her faith in God. She wrote in her autobiography, "I sing strange fruit because I have to." And she also insisted on continuing on her right as American citizen to sing strange fruit. The Federal Bureau narcotic agent Ann Slinger, he was out to destroy Billie Holiday, and I'm here to tell you. She stated in her autobiography that she started using heroin in the early 1940s during her marriage to a Mr. James Monroe. She was arrested on drug charges in 1947 and ended up spending months in jail for possession. 2 years later, Billie was once again caught with drugs by the police. Billie Holiday mostly used the following drugs: marijuana, heroin, and cocaine. However, heroin, the opiate drug, was her primary drug of choice. The heroin was her primary drug of choice. I want to present opiate type drugs before I discuss the physical withdrawal symptoms of opiate drugs such as the oxycodone, the phenothol, and etc. Billie Holiday would have experienced all of these types of symptoms of withdrawal and or side effects from her heroin addiction. And I'm going to talk about the different types of physical withdrawal and side effects from opiate addiction. And as I present that information, I want to just put a little bit more emphasis on opiate type drugs such as medications that can be used appropriately by doctors to relieve pain, including prescription painkillers like oxycodone, oxycodone, but those drugs still can be abused, hydrocodone, Vicodin, morphine, codeine, synthetic phenothol, heroin, and illegally manufactured phenothol are all opiate type drugs. How do opiates affect the body? I'm going to give a description of that. These type of drugs bound to opiate receptors in the human body and brain, blocking pain. In addition to providing pain relief, opiates can produce feelings of euphoria and relaxation, especially when misused. Taking the wrong dose, using without a prescription, can all lead to addiction and side effects. some side effects and or physical withdrawal symptoms of opiates can include nausea, constipation, confusion, and depression, drowsiness, disorientation, slurred speech, or slowed movement. During an opiate overdose, a person's breathing becomes dangerously low and stops completely. With the opiate suppressing neurological signals, the heart rate slows down also to dangerous levels. Really, the person is close to death. So, in addition, the person moves in and out of consciousness even while sitting up in a social situation. They are often referred to as nodding off or nodding in and out at the same time while they're sitting up. That's because they're moving in and out of consciousness. Opiates also quickly build both tolerance and physical dependency, which leads the user to use more and more and more of the opiates to receive the same effect. This also leads to addiction and overdose and death. And I have no doubt Billie Holiday experienced probably every last one of these withdrawal and side effects in relation to her heroin addiction. Towards the end, the legendary Billie Holiday, the beautiful Billie Holiday, body came to rest. She was tired. She really was. You know, if you watch a lot of her video uploads with her singing, towards the latter part of her career, you could literally see her body physically deteriorating. You can see it in her movement. You can just see it in her body, the way her voice changed. Billie was getting tired. She really was. So towards the end, the legendary Billie Holiday, the beautiful Billie Holiday, body came to rest. She was tired. Her work was done in singing the song, the legendary song of the century, Strange Fruit, for 20 long years prior to her death. And if you read her autobiography, she literally said in it, she had to sing that song. In 1959, Billie Holiday died of heart and lung failure in a New York Metropolitan Hospital. You know, excessive alcohol and drug use, especially heroin addiction, does damage to the heart and lungs over time. While in the hospital, Ann Slinger, the Federal Bureau narcotic agent, had her handcuffed to the hospital bed for drug possession. She was persecuted until the day she died at the young age of 44 years old. Media coverage of Billie Holiday's death only focused on her addiction and difficult childhood. The Desert Sun noted Holiday's neglect, how she neglected her health, and Time magazine ran only two sentences for her obituary. In bringing this lecture to an end, Billie Holiday lecture to an end, bringing it to a closure, I'm going to deliberately focus on that during her time, Billie Holiday again was like the symbol of everything that America had to be afraid of. Billie Holiday was resisting white supremacy all throughout her singing career. Billie Holiday sang at Carnegie Hall. Don't forget that. How many artists can literally say that they made it to Carnegie Hall? Let's put emphasis on things like that. Billie is also responsible for the song of the century, Strange Fruit. I believe that was her purpose. Brave, beautiful Billie Holiday sang Strange Fruit, no matter what the cost. And she was not, and I will repeat this, she was not control by the music industry. However, she was exploited to the highest level by the industry, but she was not controlled by the industry. She had a higher purpose, and she knew it. She knew what her purpose was. It was the same strange truth at whatever cost. Billie Holiday also, early in her career, before she got into singing, Billie auditioned to be a dancer, but ended up becoming a singer. Billie Holiday was an early reality star. A lot of people didn't know that. Billie was legendary. Billie Holiday was born April 7, 1915, 106 years ago. And still today in 2021, her music continues to be played, continuously be bought. And they have made actually two movies on Billie Holiday. I've seen the Billie Holiday movie when Diana Ross played her, but Hollywood does no justice in really presenting who Billie Holiday was. They want to only put emphasis on the drug addiction and going to jail and the rough childhood. That woman did a whole lot more, and I'm here to tell you. Her music continues to be bought, but unfortunately, the record label continues to make millions and millions and millions of dollars off Billie Holiday because she did not own her master recordings. And you know, in that era, all artists were exploited, especially the African-American artists. They were exploited by the industry to the highest level. So I want to say, rest in peace, Lady Day. I have no doubt deep within my soul, God, holy angels received you in heaven without reservations. Without reservations. God did not care that you had a drug addiction. He did not care about that. He did not care that you worked as a prostitute. He didn't care about that. What he cared about was that you sang the song of the century, Strange Fruit, because you knew you had to, and she did it at all cost. And I'm here to tell you, she did it at all costs. So ladies and gentlemen, that is my presentation on Billie Holiday, insight on her drug addiction, and also insight on what she really stood for throughout her career. You know, how many artists do you know where people, it's been 106 years ago Billie Holiday was born, and still today in 2021, she's amazing. So with that being said, please hit my subscribe button. Continue to send me your comments on uploads that you may want me to do, topics that you may want me to research. And with that being said, Simplify, Simple Fidelis, and I'm going to leave you in the care of your own conscience. Have a great evening.